Hello, my name is Mike Stone, and I'm a BigFix technical advisor for the Western United States. And I'd like to welcome you to the first video in a series of videos on session relevance. So if you're watching this video, you've probably been working with BigFix for a while, but you want to get more out of BigFix. And you probably realize that the way to do that is through session relevance. Session relevance is pretty much like regular relevance. There's basic objects and there's some familiar things. Things like property of object, name of best computers. We can separate things out a little bit. Maybe we want to look at just the ID of something along with the name. We can do that. We can get a little bit more complex and maybe do a little filtering there. We can also, maybe we're going to look at some properties. All right, so particular BES property that we want to look for. We can go a little bit deeper and maybe look for a specific property on a specific system. Maybe we want to look at a list of baselines. It's starting to look a little bit more complex. Session relevance really isn't that much different than client relevance. Just remember the four basic pillars: property of object, if then else, who's it, right? This is our standard filter, and the it without whose, or the it of an object. Keep these four things in mind, and session relevance really is not that much different than client relevance. We're just dealing with a larger set of data. For us to really get in and start this journey, I think we need to start with some tools. So that's where I'd like to go first. Show you a few ways that you can start looking at session relevance and making some queries, and we'll take a quick look at some of the resources that are out there. Okay, so the first tool I'd like to look at is actually web reports. So web reports is probably one of the primary areas you're going to be using session relevance, along with maybe the REST API. Well, there's a couple other ways you can actually utilize session relevance. But let's start here. I'm going to go ahead and log into our web UI interface on demo system. All right, so let's go over to Explore Data now that we're logged in. Okay, and I have a list of computers. Now, this is the pretty standard template that we use for a list of computers. We actually can do a couple other interesting things here. So in a similar fashion to the Fixlet debugger, there's actually a Q&A tool built into web reports. So if you don't already know about this, we're just going to go to the same URL, but we're going to plug in, instead of a custom page, we're going to plug in Q&A. And this takes us to a tool that looks very much like the standard Fixlet debugger, and we can type in a query here. So let's do something simple. We'll just do names of BES computers, and we'll click on evaluate. All right, let's try that again. Plurals matter. All right, and just like in the Fixlet debugger, the Q&A tool here gives us a bunch of answer lines. So pretty cool stuff. This is a good way to get started. There is another thing that you can do within web reports, and this is probably more deserving of its own video, and we'll get to it at some point in this series. So if we go over here to Explore Data and select Custom, we basically now have a blank slate, and we can put a query into what is essentially HTML. So anything that we put in here in a custom web report becomes HTML. So I can do something like Mike's report. By the way, I'm really, really bad at HTML, so I don't expect to be impressed here. Now, what we do have access to is a special tag. So this kind of looks like, kind of reminds me of a PHP tag set. And we can do something like this: names of as computers. Remembered the plural this time. And let's make this window a little smaller and click on preview. Oh, best computers. Okay, well, again, typing matters. There we go. And here's a list of all of my computers. Now, I will share with you one more quick thing here. When you're using session relevance in this type of environment, or in this custom report environment, these filters up above actually work. That's pretty cool. So here's another way you can start playing with session relevance. My absolute favorite tool, though, for session relevance is the session relevance tester. Let's talk a little bit about that. Session relevance tester looks kind of like this. This is the tester, and it looks very much like the Fixlet debugger. So where do we get this? Well, let's go back to the browser for a moment. And if you go to support.bigfix.com/labs, you can actually find the link there. So support.bigfix.com/labs will get you there. And there's actually quite a few different tools available. Some of these are pretty old, but you know, we're kind of pack rats at BigFix. So here's the link, and you can get to relevanceeditor.html, and you can download the latest, greatest version. While we're here in the browser, let's take a look at a couple of other resources. So everybody knows about bigfix.me. And here there's all sorts of things that you can find relevance related. There's also the BigFix forum. And you know, there's some great folks out here that monitor this and keep an eye on it. There's both internal BigFix HCL folks. There's also a lot of your peers, a lot of customers that pay attention here and are happy to answer people's questions. So in the forums, if you select all categories and narrow this down to content authoring, this is where you're going to find information around session relevance. And you could also ask questions here in this category. I would suggest signing up and start taking a look around and get involved with the community here. The main resource, though, for session relevance is going to be developer.bigfix.com. A couple of different ways to navigate this. There's the relevance language reference. So if we click here, we've got different tutorials reference. We've got an inspector search. There's a section on session relevance language. And this is a great tutorial and introduction into some of the basic concepts. There's information about the major objects that we're going to look at with session relevance. And we'll go through a fair number of these as the series progresses and look at some of the ways that some of these actually interact. The inspector search is kind of interesting. If there's something you're looking for, let's say those BES computers that we were looking at earlier. We want to narrow this down to only session relevance. We can do a session relevance search. And now our query results are going to be only things that will return the session relevance object. In this case, BES computers. So if we click on BES computers, we can see all the ways that it can be created. We can also see all of the properties. And there's quite a few. Enough with the web bits. Let's actually take a look at some examples and things we can do with the session relevance tester. All right. So quick tour here. Once you install this, you'll click on configurations, and you'll want this talking to your web reports server. Now, it actually communicates with web reports using the SOAP API. And the reason it does that is it doesn't need to take any actions. So it doesn't need the REST API. It talks directly to web reports and that database using the SOAP API. So plug in the IP address of your server with the appropriate port name. Make sure that you have an administrative account that has access. Run a little test connection, and you should get back a positive result. Okay, this is looking really good. All right, so Some of the things we can do here with the session relevance tester. Let's try our basic query here, names of Bez computers. Okay, this is really simple. And we can also evaluate, just like with the Fixlet debugger, we can hit Control Enter instead of having to actually come up here and click on Evaluate. All right, so some of the cool things that are in here. We can display data in different ways. We can display it as HTML. We can display things as a grid. We can also look at the inspector reference. So this is a list of all of our basic objects. So just as we had on the web page, this is a reference. So if we click on Bez Computer, we can see the creation methods, and we can also see all of the properties. Now, what's really, really interesting is this information is not embedded in the application. This information actually comes from the running server. So it's going to be up to date. So let's take a look at this. If you took the relevance class, and if I was your instructor, you probably learned this this query. Properties of type. All right, and here's a list of all of the various properties for Bez Computer. And this is where it's actually getting it from. It's actually getting it from the server itself. So with this tool, we can see everything that's out there, everything that's up to date. We can look at, here's Bez Action. We can look at actions, and we'll get into this and take a look at it. There's also Fixlets. There's baseline information, there's properties, all sorts of different things that we can examine here. So just a couple more quick examples, just like in regular relevance. Let's say we're looking for Bez Computers again. Names of Bez Computers. All right, pretty straightforward. I'm actually pointed at a different system. I only have two computers in here at the moment. So let's take a look at name of it and ID of it of Bez Computers. Okay, pretty straightforward stuff. So now you have a few tools to play with. You got a couple of examples you can try. In the next video, we'll work more with the Bez Computer object and maybe work on some more advanced filtering concepts. So that's it for now. If you enjoyed the video and if you find it helpful, please like and subscribe and click the notification bell to know when we've got something new for you. Thanks for watching. Bye for now.